So I will present you the Amadeus Big Data Journey. Five years ago, in 2012, I was with my team in a very, very bad situation. We were in a dead end to deliver a very important project. We were 2 months to the deadline, and the news from the field were very, very bad. We then organized a crisis meeting. Imagine the scene, 4 people in the room, everyone looking to a PowerPoint on the wall. In this PowerPoint, a lot of metrics. In the bottom right corner of the PowerPoint, a big red metric. And next to it, 2 letters, K-O. One of my technical leaders was presenting the result of the benchmark of our brand new traffic production record replay tool. And he was explaining that to be able to ingest 1 hour of data and process it, this brand new framework requires 1.5 hours. So, easy to understand that it will not cope at all with the real-time or close real-time requirement of the project. So I ask, what are our options? Big silence. And then one of my other tech leaders, Alex, say, I read something on a brand new data management framework. It's coming from Google. It sounds promising. This sentence is the foundation of the Amadeus Big Data Journey. This sentence is the start of what I will present you this evening. I will first present you the big picture. Then the challenges, the solution we provided, and the value we have currently. I am a big fan of big pictures. Like that, you will get the context, you will be able to compare with what you are, with your own challenges. So I will first present you what Amadeus is doing, why we took this journey, and also there will be some technical slides with architecture things. But first, why am I here? Obviously for the food and the beer, sure. And for the nice invitation, thanks. I am here because when I first Google on when we run into this issue with the project. I Google and then I try to understand how to get the magic recipe to build a big scale, big data platform. And I found nothing. I was finding a lot of examples. I put Hadoop on my box, I run with 100 gigabytes, etc. But to be able to get information of bid scale, enterprise-grade implementation, nothing. Not even in some summit or conference, it was very hard. So I am here to share back all the information we got with the hope that it will help some of you. Who knows Amadeus? 10%? So what are we doing? Yes. We are an IT company providing service to the travel industry, and our main business is exactly what you say. We are managing the bookings a lot of bookings in hotel airlines. What people don't know is that we are doing a little more than that. We are doing a lot more than that. For example, when you go to the airport to take a plane, then you have your nice QR code. It's heavily used in the travel industry to be able to board your plane. When you are boarding at the boarding gate, then a message is sent to Amadeus. It's sent in the Munich countryside in Erding, where our data center is. And this data is stored in our data center, a lot of data, so roughly 1.3 petabyte a day. And to operate this data, to manage it, to make sure that everything is available, it's the day-to-day work of my team. I am in operation, deep operation. So why? Because we found the solution for this project. But then we keep moving into this journey. And then we thought, why do we want to move into this data-centric? Why do we want to put in place a big data platform? The obvious reason is to provide a good platform for the BI, our business intelligence guys in the company, and to sell Amadeus business intelligence products. We have some. It's not the main reason. Perhaps this one will talk to you. I don't know in your companies, but in mine, it was like that. The data scientist, for the data scientist, it was a nightmare. Each time you wanted to bring value outside, you had to paste this maze. First, to try to dig something on some files, database, RDBMS, whatever, and then to try to find a way to get it out. It was possible, it's just that it was very, very complex. And what we think is that it will not be good if we don't move to that. We need to be ready for the future. We don't know exactly what will come in terms of technology, so I put a lot of nice buzzwords here for what we see. But in any case, this big data platform will be the basic brick to be able to manage whatever will come next. It's not the only one. Security, cloud computing, etc. will be necessary also. But it's a basic brick. So it's a very much a strategic investment to prepare our future. Who can guess how much time it took us to get that implemented? And when I say implemented, it's not ongoing proof of concept. It's implemented and we are running production service, so some of our customer-facing services. Anyone as a guest?
Less than 4 years.
Exactly. Roughly? Actually, we just finished. Okay? 5 years, almost. And we cannot say we will have to keep moving. Okay? It will never end. We started with this the project I described that we use as a proof of technology. Then we were able to provide enough added value to move to a pilot where we did a massive investment in terms of hardware. And in 2016, we were quite production ready. Okay, the pilot was out. By the way, the first plan was only 1 year for the implementation, okay? And during 2016, it was a big expansion. lot of project, a lot of data, 13 petabytes currently in the data lake, and growing exponentially. And this year we are consolidating. So governance, object store, some other things. It's a long journey. Honestly, at the beginning when we started, I would have said, yeah, okay, 1, 2 years, 2 years and a half. It was more complex than that. Here is the magic. So I put a nice logo on the right corner. Who is technical? Who is in the IT, in the data, I mean, all of that is very easy. You know all the world, yeah. So 40%, okay. So all people that didn't raise a hand, it's a good opportunity for you during the socialization after the presentation to ask what some of those words mean. I wanted to share really to make understand that to be able to build that, we had to aggregate a lot of different components, vendors, things. And it's very complex. It's in terms of operation, because we are operation, we want to operate something stable. Then when you have normally only one component, it's complex. When you have 100 that are not meant to work together, then to make sure that everything is available, it's a very big challenge. But it's a nice challenge, very, very interesting. So what we have is an analytics platform that is a big Hadoop cluster with a lot of cores to be able to compute, and we have Spark application running on it. Then we have data archive. It's where we store all the data during at least 1 year. And we can call the data from the compute cluster to the data archive or the other way around. We have what we call a unified data ingestion. It's just a framework, a middleware to be able to get data in and data out quite easily. And then two components for that are more ecosystems. The visualization tools for the data scientist, the pure BI, and then the data compute in our cluster is reused with the normal Amadeus functionalities. A good hardware slide. I mean, I am operation and I work in a data center. It was mandatory. When we started, we just look at what we needed to put in place to make sure that we will reach absolutely no limit in our implementation. So we had to build a very strong network to manage the data with big bandwidth. We have to change drastically the hardware template that we are using to adapt it. And now we are looking to some other nice things like SSD storage to improve performances and GPU-based computing for to improve some specific cases of machine learning and deep learning. Question for all the technical guys that raise their hands. So, how many days to move 600 terabytes from Nice to Munich?
4 days.
4 years?
4 days.
Hmm?
4 days.
4?
1 day by truck.
1 day by truck. It's not 1 day. It's 2. By network is 27 days, roughly. And it happened to us. It's not theoretical at all. For another project called actually the raw data archive, we had something in Nice, 600 terabytes, and then we built the new framework in Erding. And at one point, my guy came in my office and said, okay, now we need to move the data. I said, yeah, okay, and I said, we don't know how. I said, okay, try to hire a big bandwidth network line, etc. We had a look. Prices are very, very expensive to rent specialized lines. And actually, yes, the truck was the best solution. Because from a cost efficiency, okay, it was just a matter of putting the big device, so it's like that, to put it in a truck, get it in Erding, and then plug it in the data center to copy the data. That's important. For me, we are speaking a lot of big data here, big data there. What does big data mean? We discovered that here, from my point of view, big data is when you cannot do things easily based on what you can achieve. The amount of data I am manipulating is perhaps big for some other use case or for other people. Here it was really nice because 600 terabytes in our very nice network, it's okay. We can move data here, there, 600 terabytes. To move from two different locations. It was quite funny on top of that. Challenges. When we started, I was very much, I worried a lot about technical issues. What I present, what 100 components to make sure that everything works together. Actually, it was not at all the biggest challenges. We found a solution, perhaps not the best one, but at least it works. We had three main challenges. An organizational challenge, process challenge, we'll enter in detail in my company, and people challenge. We had a quite traditional organization of global operation in Amadeus. So we were very much task-based. The DBA is doing the DB, the sysadmin is doing the system, some application guys are doing some application, but mainly dealing with vendors. When we got things like Hadoop, Kafka, all those stacks, it was not possible at all to keep the same model. I mean, an Hadoop expert, it's at the same time a software guy, sysadmin, you need to understand the network, you need to have a good understanding of hardware, so you need to be very generalist. And it was a big challenge to find the good people or to train the existing one to be able to achieve that. On top of that, if you look on the market for experienced Hadoop operator or developer, we call them DevOps now. I mean, you find there is nobody. Or you need to pay him 300,000 euros, and you cannot do that. And you need people passionate with technology. Because what they know now will be outdated in a few days. So they will learn each and every day starting at the moment they start the job. Who here is in a very much process-based company? Mostly bank, insurance, things like that. Oh, it's okay. So then, I describe. My company, especially in global operation, each time you want to change something, you have a nice process that tells you you should not do that like that. Actually, it's better not to do it at all. And it was very complex when we got those new technologies to be able to get things moving, get things changing. Because each time we had a technology like Hadoop, we had to say, sorry, but the existing process is not working. We need to change something. First, we tried not to change. We tried to adapt Hadoop to the process of the company. And we lose at least 6 to 8 months trying to do so. To fail, and then to find a way to change the process. I give you a trick. It's the one we use, and it works quite well. It's a proof of concept. It was magic. We came and we say, okay, we have that, we want to do that, and then people say, no, sorry, how processes are like that, you cannot do that. We say, yes, but it's okay, it's a proof of concept. We are doing the things, we will take care of everything, we stay aside. Let's see the added value, and later on, we will, for sure, adapt to what exists. We never did. As soon as we got the things done and it was working, as we had added value, we were able just to change the process. It was a lot easier. But this one was one of perhaps the worst, the biggest challenge we had, to change the internal culture of the company to be able to integrate those technologies. Just very important for that, we should not at all change anything. PCI DSS, security regulations, we cannot play with that. So for that, we stick to what exists. Organizational. So here, I would say the buzzword, DevOps. We had people doing the code in one side, people doing operation in one other side. Again, it doesn't work. The environment is too chaotic, changing too frequently to be able to get 10 people in the loop. So we had to reorganize the teams, actually, to move from a task-based organization to a process end-to-end delivery based on organization. So it means that in my team, for example, I have DBA, sysadmin, application, MongoDB, Couchbase, everything. But if we need to deliver something, we can deliver it. We have the full end-to-end capability. And that makes a big difference. Otherwise, it would not have been 5 years. It would have been 15, perhaps, or never. Community concept. Very important to be able to get money in a company like mine, to be able to keep developing. You need to convince people, you need to get sponsors, you need to get projects that will show that what you are bringing bring added value. By doing a community and saying, hey, we have a cool Hadoop platform. If you come, we can give you, just for try, 5 terabytes, and then do whatever you want. Then a lot of people started, very few came with something at the end, but when they came, they were able to communicate to their management executive, look, there is a lot of added value. And then we started to get more project on their project, and let's say that now the budget for the platform is not anymore a problem, wherever it was at in the first years. That's important. Unfortunately, the picture is just figurative. It's not what we got. Added value, like I say, help us to develop the concept from pilot to a real product. Because by showing added value, we were able to get more people coming to us, more projects, and keep developing. The most important thing is to give added value. Even if it's a little, even if the project, the first project is very small and the added value will be only for a specific set of few people. But at least if it provides added value and it's well communicated after, then it will create something that will help you and that at least help us to develop this platform. We got added value from places we were not expecting. First, cost efficiency. And this one is very nice if you have executive. If you come with a nice PowerPoint saying cost efficiency, most probably they will give you what you need. And actually, it was real cost efficiency. Thanks to this technology, we were able to decommission TSM, so it's an old tape storage backup technology, and we are in the process of decommissioning the NAS storage in our company. We replace everything by Hadoop clusters. BI, the Amadeus BI product, for sure, they are big drivers and big users of the platform. This one, it was a surprise, security. Because for security, it's a very much data-driven, let's say, business case, user case. And when we started to communicate with the community, we got people from security say, hey, can you put all the security data in your data lake? So like that, we will be able to apply some, to put some application on it, and then to create value with that. One good example is some fraud detection. We have machine learning running to detect fraud in our systems. And operation. So, using this platform to create value for ourselves. And that's good, because first we can do it, and there is a lot to do in this area to make sure that boxes are well monitored, that the service we are running are always up and running. We are there. For data analytics and machine learning, we consider it as a success, and we consider it that it's done. It's not anymore a project. We are not investing more on it. We are now looking to the next steps. And the next step is artificial intelligence. So the last project that spawned, and that the last guys that came to us were asking, okay, can we use your platform? But we need some specific things to be able to put bots on it, to put artificial intelligence for at least 5 or 6 projects. Perhaps only 1 or 2 will succeed. But first, it's very interesting in terms of technology, and also it's creating a lot of value. So I think that the next 5 years will be as interesting as the last 5 years. And I hope that on your side, if you are in the big data flow and you want to develop your company in this area, I hope you will succeed and that I will see you in 1 year, 2 years, presenting what you achieve. Because I am in the technology since 16 years, and it's the first time I see that I see so much changes in this area. I am very happy to be part of it. Thank you.